Hello world, it's Siraj. Today we're going to be building a decentralized app, or Dapp, in 3 minutes. Let's get started. For this video, we're going to be using Embark, which is an awesome JavaScript framework for building decentralized applications. It's integrating Ethereum and IPFS. To start off, we want to go ahead and install it using NPM, which is the Node Package Manager. Once we have it installed, we can go ahead and look in our bash RC and make sure that we've linked it properly. Once we're sure we've linked it, we can source our bash and run Embark new test. That's going to create a new Embark app, just like you would generate a Django app or a Rails app. Then we can go ahead and run our blockchain. The blockchain runs on Ethereum, so we're part of the Ethereum network when we run our app. Then we can go ahead and type in Embark run, which is going to run our app on our local host, just like a Django app or Rails app at port 8000. There it is. There's our app. Now let's go ahead and see what it's like. It's just a skeleton file. We've got contracts, CSS, HTML, JS, standard things. The contracts is the interesting bit. All of the front end logic of your code works just like in a regular web app. It's the back end that is different. So let's go ahead and create our first smart contract. We'll call it simplestorage.sol, which stands for solidity, the language of Ethereum, contracts. This contract is gonna do a simple thing. It's gonna get and set an integer in our blockchain. The great thing about smart contracts as opposed to other types of contracts is it's decentralized, they're trustless. You can have dynamic code that you would deploy to, say, Heroku that lives on a decentralized network. All nodes have to verify that this code did indeed run the intended output. That's all it's going to do, and then in our CSS, 15 pixels for our margin. And then for our HTML page, we'll want to construct something more than the standard welcome to Embark. And a get button for it as well. So once we have our HTML, we want to make sure that our JavaScript works as well. So let's go ahead and create our index.js file. In our index.js file, we want three functions that run off of the DOM. Whenever the user inputs a text, we use simplestorage.set and then use the value as a parameter. The same thing for get, and we append it to the log of what just happened. In our contracts.yml, we want to make sure that we're running the contract that we've just created. So we'll say simple storage, and the argument will be however much we want to send as a currency transfer in this dApp. In this case, it'll be 100. Now you can use this for other things, like, you know, sending someone a picture on a social network or some kind of financial app or gambling or poker, or anything that involves any kind of currency or data that we want to pay people for or receive for, that's when a smart contract would come into play. And Embark will easily allow you to deploy your dApp to IPFS by just typing in Embark IPFS. So we can get and set the value right here in HTML, and you can see it's creating transactions in the blockchain. That's it. Congrats, we got our first dApp up and running. So think of Ethereum as a decentralized Heroku and IPFS as a decentralized database. You can utilize both for your dApp. For more information on decentralized apps, please check out the links in the description below. And please subscribe for more technology videos. Thanks for watching.